first time with this, taking this picture. Good for you.
Good evening and welcome in this warm evening that we're having. Our first piece tonight is Cumberland Cross by Carl Stroman. Stroman's first original work explores the rich American folk style in two sections. The first has broad moving harmonies under Shenandoah-like medley, and the second is a lively dance, reminiscent of an Aaron Copland piece. Stroman's contributions to band, orchestra, jazz band, and vocal music make him one of the most performed composer arrangers nationally and internationally. His music is heard regularly in concert settings, television, and film. Let's enjoy the beautiful sounds of Copland Cross.
Thank you. I've been informed that we have someone in the audience this evening who is a big fan of the municipal band, and today happens to be her birthday. And this is our percussion Alex grandmother. So we'll play a little happy birthday for her, and if you could sing along. And her name is Dolores, and happy birthday, Dolores.
Country tune by composer Percy Grainger. Grainger is well known for his folk tunes, including Irish Tune from Country Derry. This tune is based on a choral version that he wrote in 1928. In composing it, he said, "I had wished to voice Australian upcountry feelings as Stephen Foster had with American countryside feelings in his songs." Grainger said this of wordless singing, "Music carries its own special message to the soul." I hope you enjoy this folksy piece, Australian Upcountry. Washerwoman is a traditional Irish jig whose melody is familiar to many people in the British Isles and North America. It is one melody played when Scottish Highland dancers dance a Scottish dance to the tune of an Irish jig. It has been a crowd-pleasing tune throughout the years. Please enjoy the Irish Washerwoman.
Thank you.
Jazz Funeral depicts a traditional Dixieland funeral in Old New Orleans. It opens with a slow, mournful processional based on the hymn, Just a Closer Walk with Thee. The solemn funeral march transitions into an up-tempo celebration of life with When the Saints Go Marching In. Arranged by Jared Spears, professor of music at Arkansas State University. He has taught music theory, history, composition, percussion, and band on all educational levels. Feel free to sing along with at a Dixieland. Army in Washington. Anderson had been an invited guest, a conductor with the Boston Pops Orchestra during their annual Harvest Night. Anderson wanted to introduce a new work and composed a song about a clock with a syncopated rhythm. The idea for the title reportedly occurred to him before he wrote the music. In a few hours, he wrote the music, scored it for an orchestra, and then mailed it to the Symphony Hall in Boston. The Syncopated Clock was recorded in 1950. it was noticed by the producers of a television show called The Late Show. It was used for 25 years. Enjoy the syncopated. Bits of the next piece, a medley of hits from the Monkees, including Hey Hey, We're the Monkees, Last Train to Clarksville, Daydream Believer, and I'm a Believer. The group was originally assembled for the American TV series The Monkees, which aired from 1966 to 68. The show's producers were hoping to put together a Beatle-like band, though the Monkees made a name for themselves and put out many international hits that can still be heard on the pop and oldie stations today. Feel free to sing along to Hey Hey, We're the Monkees.
Thank you.
concert, I'd like to thank SageNTV.com for filming tonight's performance. Let's give them a big round of applause. Three Airs from Glastro by Hugh M. Stewart. The suite contains three movements: The Jolly Earl, Air for Eventide, and The Fifes of Wimberley. This piece came into being as a result of the composer's fascination with an old 10th century couplet. There's no one quite so comely as the Jolly Earl of Cholmondeley. Cholmondeley is an old English word which means pleasing and wholesome in appearance. The first movement, The Jolly Earl of Cholmondeley, is representative of the nobility of once surrounded the castle. The second movement, Air for Eventide, is contrastingly gentle and calm. The third movement, The Fife of Wimberley, may represent a few different things. A fife is actually an old English term for a fee. I hope you enjoy Three Airs from Gloucester. Gloucester. Thank you. Concert is an instrumental composition by Henry Mancini, written as the theme for the 1963 film The Pink Panther, and subsequently nominated for the 1964 Academy Award for Original Music Score. The cartoon characters created for the opening credits of this music by David DePatie and Fry Freeling was animated in time to the tune. RCA Records released the tune as a single in 64. It reached the top 10 of the Billboard Adult Contemporary chart and won 20 Grammy Awards, and was later awarded a Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award in 1995. Please enjoy The Pink Panther. Song. The anthem of the state of Zacatecas and coincidentally the second national anthem of Mexico. The song was composed in 1891 after a family gathering at the home of Fernando Villalpardo, and there had been a bet between Villalpardo and Gerardo Cardina, which consisted of writing a military march. The song was primarily in the Hidalgo Garden in the city of Zacatecas, of which it became the regional anthem. Please enjoy this Mexican. Thank you. musical with music by Jerry Bock, lyrics by Sheldon Henrick, and a book by Joseph Stein. Set in the Pale of Settlement of Imperial Russia in around 1905, Fiddler has held the record for the longest-running Broadway musical from 1964 to 1972 until Grease surpassed its run. I hope you enjoy Fiddler on the Roof.
Thank you.
And expositions, and were much sought after. The band actually saved the Midwest Fair in San Francisco. During his 40 years as a bandmaster, Sousa lifted the band to popular heights, which grossed an estimated $40 million. Enjoy the Fairest of the Fair.
Thank you.
supported the Muni Man in any way. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful evening.